Life's a marathon. It's not a sprint. Not too long ago, I was in an intensive care unit, and it seemed that all the nurses kept on saying to the family as we were struggling and waiting and watching, life is a marathon, it's not a sprint. And I understood what they were saying. They were saying, you know, we don't think this is going to go fast. Expect this to take some time. Expect this to be more difficult than you thought. Expect this to be rather arduous. I have a friend, he's since passed, but he was a marathon runner, and he ran 52 marathons in his life. And when he would talk about the marathon, he would talk about the difficulty of running a marathon. It took weeks and months to prepare, and as you prepared, you still were not quite ready. No matter how long you prepared and what you did, it was still going to be difficult. You had to persevere. You had to endure. There were going to be adversities as you struggled with this. Know it's going to be difficult and a lot longer than you thought. The early church, in the time when 1 Thessalonians was written, expected Jesus to come any minute. By any minute, I mean any minute. Maybe next week, maybe this afternoon, certainly by next year. There was that anticipation. And so when Paul wrote that letter to the Thessalonians, he was saying, be ready and alert and responsive and continue to grow in faith. Don't waste time. Be ready. Because it's a sprint. By the time Luke's gospel is written, the community is realizing it's not a sprint. He's not coming next month. He's not even coming next year. It may be a while before he comes. In fact, many of the community are already dying and already died. So what are we going to do? When will that day come? We know it's going to come, but what's going to happen? We know it's going to come, and then he started thinking, you know what? It's going to come for each of us individually, whether he comes or not. There's this wonderful little imagery in Acts of the Apostles, which scholars believe is also written by the author of Luke, where Stephen is martyred, and he sees the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. So what he's saying is that each individual will have their time. We all have to be ready and alert to meet the Lord, no matter when he comes, whether he comes for us individually or whether he comes for all of us. Be ready. And then the gospel today says to us, be alert and ready, and don't be caught up in the drowsiness of carousing, drunkenness, and the anxieties of daily life. Have you read the paper lately? Have you listened to the news? I just looked through the paper, even this morning, and every page is, beware. Oh my goodness, look at this. And if you're not worried about H1N1, you're worried about, you know, what's going to happen to you because you might live too long and you outlive your money. I don't think I'll have that problem. See? That thing, it's like, but that's really what happens. We get into this whole thing, or we become anxious about daily life, or we allow ourselves to be distracted by everything that comes along. And what the reading is saying, live your life as a person who is really running the race. Live as a person of faith. Respond here and now. Take this time as we begin a new church year, to relook at the way you respond. Make this a year of growth. Make this a year of depth of faith. Make this a time to really take on the gospel anew. Now, we have some people here who are catechumen. Who's the catechumen? Raise your hand. There you are. Hi. And what? Kelly. And then all the candidates here, they're here to deepen their faith. They're at a point in the race to say, we're going to deepen our faith. We're going to respond anew to the gospel. Now they can be then a model for all of us to say, well, if they're going to do it, maybe we better do it. Maybe we better take a look and see whether we can use this time to grow in faith and to be alert and respond anew today. Not to allow ourselves to get caught up in the anxieties of life, nor to find ourselves dawdling or distracted because it's taking so long to be attentive and responsive now, to live our life with meaning. As I was doing this research, I found a little book, you know, by Megan McKenna, and she has a series of stories, and her stories are always funny and good, and she had this little story about the monks. You know, there's two monks, there's a young monk and an old monk, classic, right? The young monk says to the old monk, you've been here for 40 years. You've been praying and responding for 40 years. You must have really grown in holiness. And the old monk says, if it isn't obvious, it probably didn't happen, huh? He says, no. He says, well, what did you learn in all those 40 years of praying and fasting and living the gospel? I've learned that you have to stay awake. You have to be alert. You have to be ready. For God comes at every moment and at any moment. You have to be ready to meet God in moments of profound joy and in times of crisis. God likes to surprise you. So be ready. What I can tell you, I learned after 40 years of being here, stay awake. My friend Jim had a t-shirt. And his favorite t-shirt, he wore it all the time. In fact, after he died, his grandson picked it up and now wears it. And he liked it because it talked about him. He considered himself an old runner even after he stopped running. And it says on it, distance running does not build character, it reveals it. Life, our life as Christians, is revealed by the way we live it. Our faith is made clear by the way we realize every day matters, every moment matters. Everything is important, for the Lord likes to surprise us. So stay awake and be ready.